It looks like an open challenge has been made by the champions. That's something unheard of. Something you wouldn't hear from the former tag team champions, the Largos. The BPA is fighting champions. It's Boba. B-O-P-A. And Boba, what's his name, oh? A team that robbed of a tag team championship opportunity at Caw K2. It faced the former tag team champions, the Largos. They had to deal with Largo rules and all sorts of illusions, mirrors, and carnival tricks. And somehow, the former tag team champions, the Largos, retain. BPA, the Valley Heart Protection Agency, since they won those tag team champions, have proven, not only in NCAA, but in OCBF, they will take on anyone and everyone. Now, Cosmos 1, Tallahassee, Zohan, they have yet to see any real action since the buyout happened. In fact, I think this is the first time they've actually seen the inside of a ring. Lex chose to not pick up their contracts. Now, one thing about the Zohan, advantage BPA right now, many might argue that the Zohan might be one of the most underrated people in all of NCAA. And we get to see some teamwork right off the bat. What I think about the keys to victory for either one of these teams. Keep in mind this, BPA undefeated since they formed as a tag team in NCAA. What this, whoever wins this match, whoa, impressive editing. I'm breaking the fourth wall. Hi, Joe. How are you? Once again, Zohan, powerbomb, double arm powerbomb. It's moves like that that make people say this guy's underrated. Schmancy roll up right there. And Tallahassee seen action for the first time since the LexCorp buyout. Fuck you, Lex Luthor. I'm sorry, thank you for the paycheck and letting me accommodate. It looks like one, two, almost new tag team champions. Before I go too terribly off topic, it's all going to come down to chemistry here. Who's got the best chemistry? While, yes, Cosmos 1 has been a tag team a little bit longer, it's going to boil down to, whoa, reversal by Tallahassee. I think it's going to break down to team chemistry here. Roll up by Boba Fett. Champs almost retained right there. Tallahassee tough as nails. And Jango Fett seeing action for the first time since the beginning of this match. Al Lake dropped with an assist by his son. The Bounty Hunter Protection Agency, once again, proven to be fighting tag team champions. You know, you would not have seen the Largos saying, hey, we want to take on the toughest tag team. Two. And we have a really competitive tag team division with the returning Terrence and Phillip, Cobra Kai. But, you know, that's all immaterial because their contracts have been taken up. I shouldn't sound like sour grapes here. Once again, Tallahassee on the high rent district and Jango Fett make him fall down. Go boom. Roll up. How he pulled that one out of his butt is beyond me. I'll say this much. This match probably will not be extremely well choreographed or pretty. Both these teams are Smash Mouth style tag type wrestlers. The Zohan probably one of the best aerial wrestlers in all of Kaw, next to Anton Dodson. And the Zohan rides the pony. And a takedown by the Zohan. One, two. Flying forearm by Jango Fett. Yeah, I'll say this. Zohan's been in the ring for a little while here. He's starting to wear down. In fact, he's been in the ring most of the time for his team. And those frequent tag team tags and those double teams is going to be the probably the deal maker on who wins and who loses. I can tell you this. One of these teams will likely win. The other one will likely lose. Likely. And Zohan in the high rent district, but Bobo is a little too quick for him. One, two, and Tallahassee almost made the save, but Zohan kicked out on his own accord. All four of these men are tough as nails. Neither one of these teams are going to go down easy. None of these men are Monica Lewinsky, who does go down easy, apparently. Whoa, amazing flying type move. He threw him out of the top, over the top rope, and then he bypressed him at the same time. You can only see something like that from the Zohan. Making sure you're paying attention, yo. Whoa, ref go down, go boom. One, two, three, four, five, six. We would have had new tag team champions. It was Abuse a Ref Day, as it always is here in NCAA. I think he was trying to set him up for an electric chair. Moonsault. One. Two, three, no, almost. I will say this. Will the Zohan trim somebody's hair? Probably not, because both of them wear helmets. But he can trim the bush. Tallahassee back in the ring. It was probably necessary for him to make that tag. Advantage BPA. Another one of those moonsaults that just doesn't quite hit the target. You should make sure your opponent's facing upwards. And Tallahassee finds himself in the non-neutral corner. Django's in the ring. Raking Tallahassee's back. Working the back area right now. Into the corner. I think he set him up for a superplex. No! He did like a Frankensteiner roll up. Did he kick out in time? No! The winners and still tag team champions! None of these men have anything to be ashamed of. They put on a clinic, Smash Mouth style. Still your tag team champions, once again taking on any and all comers. The NCAA tag team champions, Boba Fett, Jango Fett, the father and son team of BPA, the Bounty Hunter Protection Agency. Cosmos One has nothing to be ashamed of. All four of these men put it all out on the line. Here's my next favorite moment. The battle for the case full of cocaine. Just find out what Dr. Roxo will do for cocaine. here it is. Most anticipated matches. The former three-time NCAA champion, one-time OCBF champion at Raggin' Rock, one of the most accomplished wrestlers in all of Kaw. He is a fucking asshole. But he's our fucking asshole. Superman Prime. Per order of the new NCAA president, Lex Luthor, Guy Gardner is banned from going Red Lantern in this match. I don't know if this will backfire on him or not. It seems like the reoccurring theme is when Superman Prime has everything going his way, something seems to backfire at times. And here he is, back in the green suit. From Baltimore, Maryland. Guy Gardner. There's a steel cage. Let's just reflect while we look at the cage. The former coast-to-coast champion. The man who lost that tag team, lost that championship, undeservedly so. As you can see, it was a four-way match with Lobo, Ultraman, and Dashing Dick Grayson. Nightwing. He is your new coast-to-coast champion. And that's a championship Guy Gardner, if you ask me, he did not deserve to lose. Most dubious circumstances. To be continued.